morning, children. I think everybody is doing well in your home by following corona safety measures. Yes. Are you following safety measures of corona? Yes. Like sanitizing your hands, maintaining distance, wearing mask. Yes, no, children. So these are the important measures you have to follow in this time. Yes. So in the previous class, we have learned that in the lesson My Body, you have learned what are the internal organs. Yes, once again I'll give you recap of the lesson. Yes, so here in your class, the first lesson is My Body. In this My Body lesson, you have two organs, like one is internal organ and the others are external organs. Internal organs are inside organs which you cannot see. External organs are organs which you see outside. Yes. So the internal organs which you have learned in your previous class, did you remember? Yes, the organs which are inside, which we cannot see and which will play a very important role in the movement of your body and to stay safe and healthy, are internal organs. Okay, so the internal organs, what you have learned in your previous class? Yes, so the internal organs you have learned about are heart, lungs, brain, kidneys, stomach, muscles, bones. You have learned, no? You forgot? Did you remember or forgot? Yes. So these are the internal organs you have learned in your previous class, no? What are they? Did you recognize this one? Yes. This is brain. This is heart, lungs. Yes, kidneys, stomach, and liver. And apart from this, you have learned about bones and muscles also. Yes, did you remember all those points? Yes, very good. You can revise, you can recollect all those points, but once again by reading of your internal organs part. Okay, so in today's class, you are going to learn about your external organs. Okay, so these are very easy. I think you know, apart from my saying, you also know what are these organs and how they are helpful to it. Helpful to all of us. Yes. So external organs, what are they? Which we see are called external organs. Yes. So for starting for today's topic, you need your term book and your pencil and eraser. So when I am reading your part in your external organs, so wherever you find a little difficulty word, you can underline and practice. Okay. So let us start with our today's topic. Okay. So today's topic is what? Yes, external organs. So in these external organs, what are they? Yes, you can say. What you can see, all those are called external organs. Yes, what are they? What you can see? You can see your eyes. Yes. Next, nose you can see. Next, ears. Next, mouth. Yes, and after that, the first and the foremost and the very big part in our body, skin. Skin is also there, no? You can see from top of our head to our toes, the one organ which covers every part of our internal organ is skin. So these are the external organs we are going to see now. Okay. So look into your book, wherever I am reading, underline whichever word is difficult. Okay. So external organs. The organs that we can see from outside are called external organs. Yes, just now I said, no, which we can see are called external organs. Sense organs are external organs. So for these external organs, you have another word as sense organs. Sense organs. Sense means what? Which you can feel. Are called sense organs. Which you can feel. So all these parts, what we have written, are of sense organs. These all parts can feel about their each and every part. And each part will have their feeling according to that related part. Okay. Each one will not have same. All will not have the same feeling. So each organ will have an own sense, its own feeling. Okay, so let us see what it is. We have five have five sense organs. How they help us? Sight, hearing, smell, taste and touch. Sight means what? What we see is called sight. Hear, we listen. Smell, we breathe. Taste, we read, no? So that taste. Touch, we touch something and we will feel whether it is hot or cold or anything. So these are the sense organs. These are the feelings which these organs will show us. Okay? So for these senses we have five sense organs. Yes, for these all five senses we have five sense organs also. They are called sense organs because they help us to sense things around us. Yes, these all the five sense organs will help us what is happening around us. What is there beautiful? What is coming? What is the fragrance we are taking? Yes, and what is the taste we are eating? Whatever it is, these five sense organs will help us what is going around us, what is happening to us. These sense organs will help us. Okay, so first we will see the first sense organ, eyes. About eyes, our eyes help us to see. Yes, this we know. We have two eyelids, they protect our eyes. We have eyelashes on our eyelids. Yes, so what they are saying, see, these are the external organs. Yes, so this is the eye. Yes, they are saying these eyes help us to see what is there around us. And this eye have two eyelids, it is the up one and the bottom one. It have two eyelids, okay, which will open and close. And these eyelids will have two eyelashes also. Eyelashes, the hairy one which we have on the lids. Yes, so these are the eyelashes we have. Okay, so these are the things I have. And how we have to take care of our eyes, we will see. Do not rub your eyes. See, wherever you touch, wherever you go for play and whatever will happen, if something dust will come into your eyes, what you will do? You will rub your eyes. Yes, whatever the dirt or anything is there into your hand, if you rub, it will enter into your eyes. Yes, for this is the reason, whatever we have into our eyes, hands, if you rub your eyes, it will enter into your eyes. So the present situation is also for that only. How corona is spreading wherever. If you touch anything, if a corona patient is there, if you go near to that patient, yes, if that patient sneezes or coughs, if his droplets spreads on anything, and if you touch it, and if you touch any of your face, eyes or nose, if it, that corona droplets, if it enters inside, you will also become a patient. So that is the reason you have to use sanitizer or soap. Okay? Yes. So now you should not rub your eyes. Always read under a proper light. See, if you read under a dim light, it affects your eyes. Whenever you are reading or writing, you have to read under a proper light which you can see clearly. In that light you have to read, you have to do your work. Do not watch television for long hours. See, now in these days people are doing the same thing. Yes, you have to play. Yes, you are playing, watching TV and watching phones, games, cartoons. These are all the things, many things affecting your eyes. Yes, so whatever it previously what you used to do, nice, you used to come to school nicely from 8 to 8:30 to 3:30. You used to be in the school nicely, you used to play, you used to go to AV room. Yes, and different teachers are used to come, learn different things. But now you are sitting near TV or with the phone, and if that you can see, but it should be only to limited time. It will affect your eyes. You should give rest to your eyes also. You should not say, mommy, I am not getting sleep, I want your phone for games. Mommy, I am not getting sleep, I want a cartoon channel. So you should make a schedule and you should give rest to your body also. Your body also requires a rest, like your eyes. Okay, you should not watch TV or phones for long time. should wash your eyes with cold water every day. Okay, whenever you will wash your eyes, where we should wash your face daily 2 to 3 times. You should wash your face. If you keep soap or not also, with cold water you should wash your face, and with your eyes also you should wash. Whatever dust or anything is there, it will go with the water. Okay, so this is about your eyes. Eyes, what it will have? Eyes are very important to us. It will show what is around us. Eyes are having 2 eyelids, the top one and the bottom one. Yes, for eyelids you have eyelashes also. 2 eyelashes which will open and close. Okay, and how you should take care of your eyes? You should not rub your eyes. You should read under a proper time, proper light. Yes, you should wash your eyes with the cold water. Yes, and you should not watch TV or phones for the long time. Okay, this is about your eyes. Okay, now we'll move on to the next part, ears. Okay, so these are all the whatever, whether it is internal, whether it is external, no issue. All the parts are very important for a human being. Now we'll move on to ears. Ears help us to hear. So what ears will help? See how you are listening to my video, listening to my class, by using your eyes and ears. Yes, so ears will help you to listen. And ear is made up of 3 parts. One is outer part, one is middle part, and the inner ear, the inner part. Okay, the outer ear hears the first, then the sound travels into the middle ear and then to the inner ear. So what is ear will do? See, ear, here you have the ear. What is ear will do? This ear will hear the sound. What is the sound around us? It will hear the sound, whether it is a music or sound or disturbance, whatever it is, our ear will recognize what is the sound. Okay, and for this ear you have 3 parts. One is the outer part, which we can see outside. This is the outer part. And the tube, tunnel like thing, this is the middle ear, like pipe it is. So it is the middle ear. And the part whichever it is connected to your brain, the inner nerves or the muscles or the tiny slightly sensitive bones, whatever you have inside the ear, which are connected to your brain, is called inner ear. Okay, so first your ear, outer ear, listens to the sound. It will send to the middle ear. Through the middle ear it will enter into your inner ear, then the message will be passed to your ear. Okay, so this inner ear will pass the message to the brain. Okay, so these are the 3 parts you have in a ear. Now how we should take care of our ears? Never put any sharp or pointed objects inside the ear. See, few children will make something or the other, like pencil or paper, something they will keep in their mind, in their ears. That is very dangerous, children. If it enters into your brain and it enters into your ear, if it damages your, see, ear part is very sensitive part. It touches to any of your inner ear, it damages your ear, and it will affect your ear. Okay, so you should not keep anything sharp or pointed things in your ear. Avoid listening to loud music. See, whenever your favorite song will come or anything, your favorite things comes, whatever you will do, you will raise the sound and you will hear. No, that thing you should not do. You should limit the volume and you should listen to the music. We should clean our ears with a soft cloth or earbud. See, regularly you should clean your ears. Yes, and the cleaning work also should be done with the soft things, not with the hard or sharp things. You should clean your ears with the soft cloth or earbuds. Okay, this is about your ear. Now we will move on to our next part, nose. Okay, so the next sense organ, next external organ is nose. Okay, the nose helps us to smell. What nose will do? Yes, nose will help us in smelling the things. We breathe with the help of our nose. Yes, we will breathe with the help of our nose. Taking care of our nose. So how, see, now we have seen about the nose, no? How, what is the work nose will do? Nose will help us in taking the smell. See, whenever your mummy is cooking anything in the kitchen, what you will say? Mummy, nice smell is coming. Mummy, what you are doing? Mummy, mummy, you are doing any sweet? Or biryani you are doing? You will ask, no? Mummy, very nice, tasty smell is coming. Mummy, what you are making? You will ask, no? Or if your father bought anything from outside also, you will ask, daddy, nice smell is coming. What you bought? Mirchi bhajis or cakes or chocolates? You will ask, no? So, how you are asking all those things? With the help of your nose. Nose is recognizing the smell, whatever is around you, and it is passing message to your brain, and to your brain will pass message to your mouth. Mouth is asking. Okay? So, the smelling things work will be done through the nose. Okay? Now, how you should take care of your nose? Use a soft tissue or handkerchief to clean the nose. So, whenever you want to clean your nose, you should use soft tissue or soft clothes or soft handkerchief to clean the nose. Okay? Do not put your finger or any other objects inside the nose. See, few children, they will have a habit of keeping fingers in the nose, mouth, ears, no? So that you should avoid. You should not keep your hands, fingers in any of the face part. Okay? You should not keep anything in the nose. Always cover your nose with a handkerchief or tissue when you sneeze. Yes, always what you should do? You should keep handkerchief or any soft cloth to cover your nose whenever you are sneezing. See, this is also a safety measure of this corona now. We are wearing mask, no? See, why we are wearing mask? Because if somebody sneezes or if we itself sneeze, our droplets should not fall on others. But that is the reason we are wearing mask. So mask is also a kind of kerchief. So whenever you are sneezing, you should use your mask or kerchief. Mask is also a kind of kerchief, no? Nowadays we are everybody is using mask only. Yes. So you should use whatever it is, you should use soft things for covering your nose. Okay, so this is about your today's class. We will meet today. Whichever topics we have finished, we have learned about eyes, we have learned about nose, and we have learned about ears. So whatever we have here, see the five sense organs here. From these five sense organs, we have learned about three sense organs here. The other two sense organs, we will learn in the next class. Thank you.